everyone. My name is Chakravarti from Energy Security Graduate Program. Today I will present my paper entitled Biofuel Industry Challenges to Farm Oil-Based National Energy Plantation. Introduction: Indonesia has enormous potential to produce palm oil-based biofuel. The biofuel ingredients include green diesel, green gasoline, green ethanol, and green LPG. Palm oil is a vegetable material that has the most influence on energy supply in Indonesia. By using biofuel, it is expected to be able to inhibit the growth of fuel import in Indonesia. The author aims to write the challenges of the biofuel industry against oil palm-based energy plantation. Literature study. The study discusses the extent and potential of using oil palm-based energy plantation in Indonesia and the challenges it poses to the biofuel industry. Method. The research was conducted using qualitative method. Data collection technique uses secondary data in the form of descriptive analysis. The next research and discussion, potential of oil palm plantation for biofuel. Palm oil is the most efficient source of oil-producing raw materials compared to other vegetable oil-producing plants as biodiesel because, broadly speaking, oil palm fruit consists of fruit flesh that can be processed into CPO and TKO. In the figure, it can be seen that Indonesia consists of many forests and can be used optimally for energy plantation needs. In the next development of Indonesian biofuel industry, the biofuel industry shows an increase both in term and quantity and capacity. The biofuel industry, bioethanol and biodiesel has been increasingly developed since 2005 for more effective support. Biodiesel business requires a grid and format an organization at the end of 2006. The organization was established under the name APROBI, Association of Indonesia Biofuel Producers. Analysis of challenges in the development of energy plantation and the biofuel industry. So the expansion of oil palm plantation is still widely carried in forest area and national park illegally and informally. And as a result, there has been a plan to implement Renewable Energy Directive 2 by the European Union, which will phase out the use of palm oil as a biodiesel feedstock until it's completely banned by 2030. The next, the picture below in the value of export and import of CPO. In 2019, almost all commodity export in the industrial sector experienced a decline. Export for commodities produced by the base metal industry, palm oil commodity as a leading commodity to increase the country's forest exchange experienced a decline. In 2019, the export value of palm oil decreased. In 2019, the most widely imported vegetable oil by European Union countries is palm oil, 16% from Indonesia and Malaysia. The table above shows statistics on CPO import by several European countries in 2017 and 2020 explained that European countries still import CPO from palm oil producing countries such as Indonesia and Malaysia. Sustainable oil palm plantation to support the sustainable development goals. Issues the latest Indonesian sustainable palm oil regulation, which is contained in the Presidential Regulation of the Republic of Indonesia number 44 of 2020. This article explains about providing understanding regulation and follow-up to various things that Indonesia aspires to develop and support oil palm development. Indonesia's sustainable palm oil and sustainable development goals are too important in realizing and advancing the development of Indonesia oil palm plantation so that they can work towards sustainable and environmentally friendly oil palm plantation. Effect of Renewable Energy Directive policy on Indonesian biofuel industry. In 2019, the European Union officially issued regulations related to the Renewable Energy Directive 2 policy. The policy stipulates palm oil as a renewable energy raw material that is high risk and unsustainable. The deforestation due to oil palm plantation and all of them occur in areas with high carbon stock. The causes the European Union to palm to greatly reduce the use of palm oil from 2024. Several countries exporting biofuel raw material source as Indonesia says that the implementation of the Renewable Energy Directive policy in threat in palm oil and the biofuel industry. In the picture beside are recommendations for oil palm plantation and the development of CPO or PKO, future studies and cooperation in the development of oil palm-based energy plantation are needs with agency, government institution, and university in order to obtain sustainable palm oil-based energy plantation. Conclusion: the government will increase the use of CBO-based biofuel from palm oil mills as a sustainable and reduced fuels import with various government regulations and policies implemented to support biofuel. Indonesia has enormous potential to produce palm oil-based biofuel. Oil palm plantation have a potential to be used as energy plantation. The last Indonesia sustainable palm oil regulation was used in Presidential Regulation of the Republic of Indonesia number 44 of 2020, containing the Indonesia sustainable palm oil plantation certification system. With the existence of palm oil-based energy plantation as well support Indonesian energy needs and become a mainstream product for import. And thank you.